Hello learners, in this session we will learn about the 86th amendment to our constitution. You are already aware that in 1990 when we had the Jomshin conference, then education for all, it was identified as the most important goal to be achieved by all nations all over the world. India was a party to it and it agreed that it will take all the initiatives, bring about all the necessary changes and new policies and strategies will be adopted to ensure that elementary education is universalized, which means that there will be universal access provided to all learners who are in the age group of 6 to 14 to school. That education will be made within reach of these students. It was also said that once they are enrolled, it was found that many students are not able to complete their education, they drop out or they are not able to achieve well. Hence, what happens that they have to repeat the class. Now it becomes a demotivation for the learners and many of them when they go further down then they drop out. So that universal retention was also a very important goal which was to be achieved by our Government of India. Besides universal retention, universal achievement. That when we talk about education, education should not be something that learners are going to the school, they are attending the classroom, they are coming out of it and that's it. Education is meant for preparing them for life. That means their knowledge base should be increased, their attitudes should be modified, moderated and shaped with adequate experiences and requisite life skills are imparted to them so that once they are out of the school portal, they are actually able to use those skills and lead a successful life so that they are able to play a significant role in the society and become a worthy member of their community, thus promoting the progress of their family, their community and the nation and world at large. So with these objectives, in 1990, in the Jomshin conference, everybody declared that, okay, we are going to make substantive efforts towards the realization of the goals of universalization of elementary education. Now, 10 years down the line, when it was time for report taking, then unfortunately it was found that many countries were far behind the realization of these goals. And the reasons were multiple, they were varied. So when in Dhaka they met once again in 2000, efforts were made to find out that how they can plug in the holes, the missing link, how can they ensure that the strategies which the government is coming out with, it reaches the masses and the masses are able to make the best of it. So once again, all the countries avowed that, okay, we are going to ensure that all these policies, these strategies, they percolate down to the masses in the community. And it was realized that it cannot be done unless and until the community is involved. Okay, so involvement of community and of all the active stakeholders of education, it was realized that this is very, very essential. Following this, in the year 2002, Government of India enacted the 86th amendment in the constitution, which was passed by the Indian Parliament. The short title and commencement of this amendment goes like this. This act may be called the Constitution Act 2002, also referred to as the 86th amendment. It shall come into force on such date as the central government may, by notification in the official gazette, appoint. Next, in this act it was also mentioned, there was an insertion of new article 21A. So after article 21 of the constitution, the following article shall be inserted, namely right to education. Now this 21A goes like this, the state shall provide free and compulsory education. Please underline these words, that provide free and compulsory education to all children of the age of 6 to 14 years that is the elementary age group, in such manner as the state may by law determine. So now the responsibility is there with the state, and it has the freedom to exercise this right, this law, in its own way. It further stated substitution of a new article for Article 45. For Article 45 of the Constitution, the following article shall be substituted, namely, provision for early childhood care and education to children below the age of 6 years. When we talk about elementary education and we just talk about 6 to 14 years age group, then one major problem which was identified was that the girls were not able to get enrolled in the schools because they were given the responsibility of looking after their younger siblings at home. The government had announced, and they had in fact taken initiative of opening Balwadis and Anganwadis to assist these girls, that okay, when you are going to school, then your younger siblings will be taken care of by these workers of Anganwadi and Balwadi. But somewhere it was not happening. Somewhere the girls were still not able to go and reach the school. So now a provision was made for early childhood care and education to children below the age of 6 years. And the state shall endeavor to provide early childhood care and education for all children until they complete the age of 6 years. So this is also now entrusted with the state, that it is their responsibility. They have to take up those constructive steps, measures and strategies to ensure that early childhood care and education is also provided. Because unless and until the learner is ready for the school, to enter the school, he will not be able to succeed well in the school. So that learner readiness, the community readiness, again that has to be prepared, and the state has to play a significant role in that. The 86th Amendment to the Constitution approved in 2002, providing free and compulsory education to all children aged 6 to 14 years, has been notified. Along with this, the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act, which was passed by Parliament, was also notified to enable the implementation of the 86th Amendment. Article 21 of the Constitution is related with the protection of life and personal liberty. A child is also an individual. He also has the right of protection of life and that personal liberty. Article 21A was added after Article 21. You will appreciate that Article 21A makes the right of education of children of the age group of 6 to 14 years a fundamental right. When we talk about human rights, then human rights doesn't mean that we are just talking about the people who are struck in the war zone or who are deprived, who are marginalized. Children are a very vulnerable section of the society. And when we are talking about the welfare of an individual, of a human being, we have to ensure that we are giving the welfare and care to our children as well. So announcing that, okay, now this is a fundamental right, it is actually empowering the parents and the children that they have a right to be educated. Article 51 of the Constitution includes 10 fundamental duties of citizens. By virtue of this amendment, 11th fundamental duty is added, which reads as follows: to provide opportunities for education to his or her child or ward, as the case may be, between the ages of 6 to 14 years. So that means the parents are also coming under this duty. It is their duty that if they have a child, they have to provide for the education of that child. So to give education to their children or ward has now become a fundamental duty of every citizen. So that shows that how the government is trying to take up more strong measures in order to ensure that elementary education is being provided. Universalization, the goals of universalization of elementary education are achieved. Because if our base is strong, then definitely our nation will progress further. But if we are neglecting our base, then it will somewhere or the other affect our workforce of the adolescent group and later on of our general population. Now here I must remind you that India is a signatory to the Convention on the Rights of the Child, that is CRC, and is therefore committed to bringing its internal legislation in line with the agreements in the ratified CRC. That means the rights of children have to be provided for, and it is the responsibility of the government, the parents, the members of the society to ensure that the child's rights are protected. One of the major articles in the convention commits India to state parties recognize the right of the child to education, and with a view to achieving this right progressively and on the basis of equal opportunity, they shall in particular, number one, make primary education compulsory and available free to all. Thus, the amendment is in consonance to this commitment also. So, when we are talking about the rights of a child, we have to ensure that we provide them nutrition, we provide them education, we provide them the necessary respect and acceptance of their community values, their family norms, and the right to excel in every field, which is possible only if they are given the opportunity to read, write, learn properly in a school. So learners, we see how our government is expressing its sincerity towards the realization of the goals of universalization of elementary education, and this 86th amendment was a significant effort by the government of India to ensure that each and every member of our society, be it the local bodies, the parents, the schools, the panchayats, the district level administrators, the state, the other policy makers, whosoever, all the primary stakeholders of the education system, that they are gearing their machinery up to ensure that elementary education is provided to the learners. It has entrusted the responsibility of education of children on each one of us. So, we should all make our concerted efforts to ensure that this learning experience for our learners is meaningful, interesting, useful, making them worthy citizens of our country. Thank you, learners. With this, we come to the end of the session, and we'll meet again in the next session.